not even president. You have derangement syndrome.
Yeah.
No, he's still you,
you're
Mario
listen
Puzo.
To, yeah. You're, listen. Oh, you just
my light.
Off,
I got excited.
You just turn off the lights in your little studio. He was doing Trump puppeteering.
Yeah.
And, okay. All right.
I got there.
Yes, he said the only powerful tool Republicans have to negotiate with is the debt ceiling, and they would be both foolish and unpatriotic not to use it now. You see what he's doing? It would be unpatriotic not to blow up the full faith and credit
right.
of the United States. This yep. is the upside down word. He said, unrelated, but likewise, their so-called voting rights bill would be the end of our democracy.
He's right.
Okay.
It'll be the end of Republicans participating in democracy because you'll never win another election.
Yes, yes.
As you shouldn't, because you don't come with ideas.
Yeah. I don't.
You come with obstruction.
We had
and religion.
Representative Scanlon on earlier. I don't know how you negotiate with terrorists. I mean, it's I don't know what's going to happen to you with all this negotiation going on this week. All of these bills and the debt ceiling, it really is negotiating with crazy people.
Yeah.
We are we're Sandra Bullock in Speed. And I don't know.
Yep.
It's the crazy Dennis Hopper character. That's who they are.
Yeah, and we can't go below 55.
No, we can't go below 55, Chris. Where's Keanu Reeves? Where is he?
Yeah, we're going to have to put the lotion in the basket.
Yeah, or it gets the hose again.
Right.
Or we're going to get the hose again.
Oh, my God. Okay, so this sedition memo. In the final weeks ahead of the January 6th vote to certify the election, Pence consulted with Judge Michael Luttig, who just tweeted, he recalled, I believe that Professor Eastman was incorrect at every turn of the analysis in his January 2nd memo, beginning with his claim that there were legitimate, compelling slates of electors presented from seven states. He said that if former vice president had followed Eastman's conclusion, it would mean the VP could unilaterally decide not to count the votes from the seven states from which competing states were allegedly presented. I mean, this is just craziness. I don't know if you read this memo, this sedition memo, but it literally is just, they picked seven states to just say, oh no, here's competing electors. Mm-hmm. Not what the people voted for, Joe Biden, but no, these electors say it was Trump, and then boom, we're done.
Yep.
Our 245-year experiment is done, right?
It's super frightening. There's not enough, unfortunately, and I hate to say that, there's not enough Liz Cheney's in the world in the Republican Party.
Daddy.
There's not enough of me, Daddy. I'm trying. Mitt Romney's on my team, but he's so bland, Daddy. He's like a cold coffee with cream.
There's not enough people with daddy issues, is what you're saying?
No.
Okay. Robert in Florida, how you doing? You're on with...
Hey, buongiorno.
Hey, how you doing? Hi, Robert.
Hey, I'm here. Hello.
Go ahead.
Can you guys hear me or no?
Yes.
Yes! Just go.
Hey, I don't know what phone you people have. You know who I know is happy you guys have phones? It's Chris and the Candleman, because next week with no phones, we'd be hearing a lot about, you know, comic books and cats and what else? Candles.
Candles, lots of candles,
bandedmasculine.com. Yes, we'll all be about candles, cats, and comic books next week. Yes.
Sounds like an awesome show.
Yeah, all right, whatever. No, my hold on. What I want to call about is, I talked about is, these people now that understand that Donald Trump lied about with the Dominion and everything like that, people are sitting in jail thinking, why did I show up when he knew all along that this was a lie? How about the parents of the girl Babbitt that wanted to sue the police officer for shooting their daughter, which I believe, she was a terrorist, and I have no problem with that. But maybe they should sue Donald Trump for sending her there, because if there's no, stop the steel rally, she don't go to D.C. She's alive today.
Yep.
I mean, there's a lot of people that this guy, he screwed up a lot of people's lives. All right, listen, I got to go. I got to move the truck.
Oh, okay. Well, thank
but
you
know,
for
Bob,
that. Just please don't move the truck.
I could get somebody shot at the Capitol and nobody would do a thing, okay? And I've done it. And nobody's doing anything. He's
By
right.
the way, do you remember the latest? Was this, 2 days ago? The latest Biden crisis? Chuck Todd, Carnival Claw, credibility crisis on the world stage. Got France. Okay, that's over now. Just so you know. See what I mean? Do you see what Eric Bollert and I mean about the media coverage of Biden? What is...
Biden
the White House released a statement announcing they've reached a path forward with France despite recent tensions over the U.S. submarine deal with Australia. Mm-hmm. He spoke to President Macron, that's as adults do, as people that know how to do diplomacy do. Oh, my God.
He said that it could have been handled better.
France said their ambassador will return to Washington next week. So what's Carnival Claw going to talk about this? It's just like everything is some Biden crisis, stumbling, horrible.
Yeah, they're just like Republicans. They don't want to lose that audience that, like, oh, I don't want to offend an audience that might be teetering here. Just,
right.
Biden's not perfect. But he's way better than what we had, dudes.
Yeah.
Way better.
So Trump is bleeding. It's bleeding attorneys. Is that the headline?
Yes.
Yeah. And legal experts say that is not normal. Yeah, we passed normal quite some time ago. He faces more legal challenges than ever. He's lost all of his high profile lawyers. Mark Kasowitz, mm-hmm. Jay Sekulow, Mark Mukasey just withdrew himself. That was from the Trump Organization thing, Charles Harder, remember the Gawker guy?
Yeah.
So now he has Alina Haba. Mm-hmm. It's the one that just filed a lawsuit against his... Is she the one? Oh, she's the one that served as general counsel for a parking garage company?
Yes.
Oh, that lady is his lawyer now against Mary Trump and the New York Times. Mm-hmm. Okay.
I think Mary Trump and the New York Times can afford better lawyers than that.
I lost my favorite part of the book when he said he only had Rudy because he couldn't get anybody else. He's like, I know he's crazy, but like, I couldn't. Nobody else will do it. That's a ringing endorsement.
If you want to be with me, you got to keep up the hair dye, okay? Darker. Go darker.
All right. I can't get enough I'm Eric stories. I'm Eric! So that was Eric's lawyer that quit. He had a complete meltdown, according to the Woodward book. On election night, he was yelling at the campaign's data analysts as if it was their fault. His father's early leads were shrinking. He said, "We pay you to do this. How can this be happening?"
Oh, God. Oh,
what a privileged little douchebag. He's probably been like that all his life, right? We pay you. Three of Trump's children kept showing up and pestering aides. Eric asked for data his father could cite in a speech. He grew frustrated when told the numbers would continue to change. States were still counting. Oh, dear. Poor little
Make
Eric.
My daddy win.
Yeah, you don't get it.
Make my daddy win.
I don't get mad.
How does counting work?
Yes, exactly. It's like someone had to explain counting.
Why are the numbers getting bigger? God.
Poor Eric. All that money, and they still couldn't fix it.
Somebody tweeted a picture. They said, "Forget Hunter's laptop. Have you seen Eric's?" You know, it was like
that's a sketch.
A play school thing. It was like a play school.
Where'd I put my Casio keyboard? It's in Eric's mouth.
He's the Brian Kilmeade of the Trump administration.
Oh my God. Oh, my God. Yes, he doesn't have to expand everything to him. Counting, math.
Tides.
The tides. Okay. When the sun comes up and goes down. Okay.
Yeah. All right. Every day it's a surprise for Eric.